Renters in New South Wales may no longer be forced to pay extra fees. The Minns government will introduce new legislation next month designed to modernise the system. Property owners and agents would be required to offer fee-free ways to pay, including bank transfers and the federal government's centre pay service. Owners would also no longer be able to refuse pets without a reason, and refusals would need to be submitted to a tribunal. Joining me live now is Tenants Union of New South Wales CEO Leo Patterson Ross. Leo, thanks for your time. What do you make of the reforms? Do they do enough in your view?
Good afternoon, Kieran. Look, these are really important reforms, and we do need to see the actual drafting, the actual words of the bill, because as with everything, the detail matters. But in a general sense, we are feeling like this is a positive reform. It is delivering largely on the election commitments and other commitments made by the New South Wales government that will make a difference in the lives of renters. The really big headline here is the confirmation, really, that the no grounds eviction reform is coming in this bill, and that will really make for a better relationship between landlords and tenants. But the pets changes, the break fees or the charges for paying rent, these are all going to make a real difference in the experience of renting.
Can you explain the situation when it comes to fees? What's the problem there?
So there's a couple of fees that are being addressed here. One is the background checks that up to one in three renters are reporting that they're feeling pressure to pay for it, their own background check as part of the application process. Because things are so competitive, because it's so hard to find a place, people are putting forward that you should pay for your own background check and put it in as part of the application. And that's not really demonstrated to actually make any difference in your success, but it is costing you $20, $30 a pop for mostly information that should be given to you for free. And then there's the fees for paying rent. And we've seen that the legislation in New South Wales already says that you need to be given a fee-free way to pay. But those fee-free ways have increasingly become inconvenient, cash in the office or buy checks for people who don't already have a check account. And so really this is about modernising, bringing us into the 21st century where everybody can transfer a bank and do it for a very low fee.
And finally, on the pet question, those dog lovers of us would very much empathise with tenants or people that would want to have their pets with them. And what's this about? Because some owners might be saying, well, if I don't want a pet or an animal in the house or the apartment, why should they be forced to have it? But I guess the counter argument is it's very hard to see someone broken up from their ownership of a much-loved pet.
Yeah. So, look, at the moment, the Act, the tenancy law, is actually completely silent on pets. It doesn't give any guidance one way or another about what's supposed to happen. And so a large part of this is actually just giving direction, letting people know what is reasonable, what's in line with community expectations. But to the point of, people who are worried about pets, I think that there's a bit of mythology about the amount or the risk of damage or cleaning. These things do happen, but renters are responsible to return the property back in the same condition. They already have a bond, and that system actually works really well already. But I think it's a deeper question as well. Are we really telling adults whether they can make decisions about them and the way that they live their lives, including the decision to take in pets? Why is that decision sitting with somebody else? Why can we not make that decision for ourselves in line with, the Companion Animals Act, council regulations? There's already so many rules. So I think this is really asking how much control should one person in the community have over another person's life?
Leo Patterson Ross, great to chat. Appreciate it. Thanks for your thoughts.
Anytime. Thanks.